Grafana 12 is officially here, and boy, do we have a lot to cover, especially if your job entails keeping teams, services, and a heck of a load of dashboards organized. My name is Sean Pitts, and in this TLDR, we're going to hit you with the highlights fast, starting off with how Grafana 12 lets you version, validate, and deploy dashboards like any other code base in your organization. Let's jump in. With the new Foundation SDK, you can now write dashboards as strongly typed code. This means they're predictable, testable, and ready to drop into your CI/CD pipelines. It's all backed by a refreshed set of API schemas and has language support for Go, PHP, TypeScript, Python, and Java. But if you prefer to create dashboards in the Grafana UI, GitSync brings the whole observability as code workflow full circle. The setup is super fast. Just connect your repo, plug in your access token, and decide how you want to sync. You can go all in and mirror your entire Grafana instance to Git, or target a specific folder if you want to keep things scoped and tidy. Once it's up and running, any dashboard edits gets tracked and saved as Git changes. Update a panel, hit save, and instead of going live immediately, GitSync opens a new branch and creates a pull request. Those changes are now private to the editor. That means no surprises for the rest of your org. Reviewers can jump straight from GitHub into the updated dashboard preview. Thanks to auto-generated links and comments, this process is now streamlined. Just merge the PR, jump back into Grafana, and with one click, the dashboard changes are made to your instance. And don't worry, we didn't forget about the Terraform crowd. Grafana 12 doesn't just throw you a bone, it's dropping an entire toolset here. We're talking about a brand new dashboard resource structure that brings more flexibility, predictability, and yes, validation. The new resource model gives you explicit control over things like UIDs, titles, and tags without hacking around in raw JSON. But the real magic is in the validation. In older versions, if you made a mistake, like accidentally setting a panel's height to a negative value, Grafana would technically accept it, but then quietly ghost the panel. Now, Grafana tells you exactly what went wrong, down to the field and index. Hey, panel zero's height can't be negative 23. That's the kind of tough love we like from our infra tooling. And it's not just dashboards. Playlists now follow the same consistent schema pattern: metadata, options, and spec. That means less mental overhead when provisioning different resources and a smoother path as more elements adopt this format in the future. Yeah, I hear you. Automation is cool, but what about the actual experience of using Grafana? Well, Grafana 12 has made some massive strides when it comes to usability and performance. We all know dashboards can get messy real quick. There's too many panels, too many variables, and a sea of data points that sometimes are unneeded all at once. With Grafana 12, dynamic dashboards transform how you edit, organize, and optimize your dashboards. Auto-grid snapping now lines up your panels instantly into clean, responsive layouts. You can fine-tune layouts even further by setting minimum column widths, like narrow, and row heights, like short, giving you precise control across different screen sizes. But a layout is just the start. Imagine you have a variable like engine name in your dashboard and only want to show specific panels and rows based on the set value. Now we can do just that. As seen here, we will hide this bottom row of panels when the template variable engine name equals SQLite. We can show the top panels to auto-fit in four columns and hide a panel when the query result has no data. Organizing dashboards is better than ever as well. You can now group panels into tabs or rows. Drag your panels into a new row, set a max column count, say 4, and Grafana responsibly reflows everything automatically. All of this adds up to a faster, cleaner experience. And that theme of speed continues. The new blazing fast table panel is a full-on engine rebuild. It handles massive datasets with ease. We're talking 40,000 plus rows, multi-column sorting, filtering, and text wrapping, all silky smooth. It's not just fast, it's absolutely frictionless. And while we're making things smoother, let's talk alerts. Grafana supports two alerting models: data source alerts, which are evaluated at the source, like Prometheus, Mimir, or Loki, and Grafana Managed Alerts, which are evaluated and routed by Grafana itself. Grafana Managed Alerts unlocks some powerful advantages. They work with any data source, not just Prometheus, Loki, or Mimir. They support granular access control. For example, you can decide who can view, edit, or manage alert rules or contact points. And the authoring/creation experience is just better. And to those users who are already ingrained with traditional data source alerts, we want to make the migration process quick and easy for you. Grafana 12 introduces a managed alert migration tool that makes moving your legacy data source alerts into Grafana managed alerts very simple. Right from the UI, you can select your alerts, decide where they land, choose to pause them to avoid noise, and even pull recording rules along with them.
The original rules stay in place so you can run both in parallel, making migration safe, reversible, and way less stressful. Basically, we finally made moving fast without breaking things the default, not the exception. And Grafana 12 doesn't just run faster, it looks sharper too. We're moving past basic light and dark themes with five new styles. Desert Bloom, a softer, colorful palette that's easy on the eyes. Gilded Grove, more natural tones for a clean, earthy feel. Gloom, a bold, high-contrast dark theme. Sapphire Dusk, which brings out deep blues for a calm, focused workspace. And Tron, a futuristic neon look for when you want to turn up the intensity. And if you've ever needed to mash up data from different sources, like logs from Loki and BI data from Salesforce, traditionally that meant exporting to a central warehouse, writing ETL jobs, or giving up and just doing math in a spreadsheet. Grafana 12, we're bringing SQL expressions to the table, literally. In our demo, we're pulling logs from Loki, which is Query A, and revenue data from BigQuery, Query B. From Query A, you can see we select fields like committed ARR, instance ID, year, month, billable series, and the sum of attribution. Then we join that data with BigQuery using the org ID field as the key, aligning metrics from two completely different systems. This breaks down data silos without needing an ETL pipeline or a centralized data warehouse. Just write an SQL expression, transform what you need, and visualize it, all in one panel.
Okay, so your dashboards are automated, beautiful, and blazing fast, but what about your users, right? Teams change, people join, and people leave. So how do you keep all access clean and up to date? That's where SCIM comes in. Grafana 12 brings full support for SCIM-based provisioning, making it dead simple to sync teams straight from your top identity providers such as Okta, Azure AD, and more. You can onboard entire teams, assign them to on-call schedules, and get them ready to receive alerts from day one. When someone leaves, their access is revoked automatically. No delays and no manual cleanup. So yeah, Grafana 12 isn't just a version bump. It's a full-blown upgrade to how teams build, scale, and run observability. Thanks for watching. We can't wait to see what you build with Grafana 12 and tune into the next video.